సభకు నమస్కారం. దసరా సందర్భంగా మీ అందరికీ నా శుభాకాంక్షలు. ఈరోజు మనము సాంస్కృతి అధ్యయన కేంద్రాన్ని ప్రారంభిస్తున్నాము. మీ అందరికీ నా అభినందనలు. నాకు ఈరోజు ఈ కార్యక్రమానికి ఆహ్వానించడం, నన్ను ఈ కౌన్సిల్లో మెంబర్ చేయటానికి నా ధన్యవాదాలు. కాస్త ఇంగ్లీష్లో చెప్తాను నేను. Not to make sure that I carry all the audience with me, and also will make sure that I'll maintain the time. We as Indians have enormous amount of cultural heritage with us. We're all extremely proud about what our past was. The past is extreme glory. I mean, I think about my past, I get goosebumps on my hands. My heart flows with more amount of blood. That's what my past is. But past, we all have to recognize, is history. Past got blemished because of invasions that happened in 7th century. We got a foreign rule for as many as about 300 or 400 years. But I think what we have as an opportunity at this point of time for us is to live in the present. That is the reality. And look at the future. That's what we need to do. So look at what the present is. The present certainly is also challenging as much as you look at opportunities. You have a crisis with COVID-19, which is challenging both lives as well as the livelihood. We have global tensions all around. And as a result of that, the supply chain are being disrupted in a big way all around the world, whether it's the US-China, whether it's the Brexit, or whether it is with our challenges we have with our neighbors. But what we also do not completely recognize, and which has helped us in the COVID-19 situation too, is enormous amount of play by technology. Technology today is bringing about an unheard about acceleration in terms of digital transformation. You look at our lives at this point of time. In a normal course, a meeting of this nature, we'd also would have been in a large conference hall, looking at each other. But doesn't allow us today. Did we stop from doing it? No. Something else is allowing it to do it as good as that. And that is technology, a virtual platform of this nature. So the technology of today certainly helps us in terms of building future. So the point I like to make is, let's very realistically and pragmatically look at what the present is. We need to understand what the present is and optimistically build the future. And in order to do that, I think we certainly have to look back at our past, look back at, rediscover our past, rediscover our roots. It's only with them we build our future. So I think two areas that I'll very briefly touch upon is areas one I think requires enormous amount of attention, which will also bring back our culture, our samskriti, is making sure we get the right education. This country has enormous amount of advantage today in terms of demographic dividend. The people who are the working population of 16 to 60 years is more than 50%, and no other nation is enjoying it today. In the past, there are a couple of nations which enjoyed. So the result is, unless today we are in a position to educate our people, give them the right education, we will not be in a position to become a great nation. And I think government did right in making sure we got something called the NEP 2020, National Education Program 2020. Many elements of it are in the right direction. The government came out with another initiative called Skills India, Skill India. There is that is another great initiative, because without skills, just bookish knowledge, I think Mr. Varaprasad referred to learning all about mathematics, physics, or chemistry, or biology, geology, does not make a person holistic. You got to have the left brain and the right brain. You have to have the ability to work with your hands and so on and so forth. That's the skilling part that's coming. Or the second part of it is, we as a nation have to build more amount of entrepreneurs. We need to create those jobs. Unless we have livelihood for people, to me, in my perspective, there'll be anarchy. So the result is that we need to create an ecosystem which will create more amount of jobs for ourselves. I think the government came out with an amazing policy called the Atmanirbhar Bharat. And to support Atmanirbhar Bharat, there are many other elements that go along with it. I think the key to us will lie in making sure. Yes, thank you. The key to us will lie in making sure that we execute these policies well. I think where we have to play a role, in my perspective, is supporting the government. There are initiatives that are there. I think they're the right path. But make sure that they get executed. They should not remain as it is. That is my submission to this August audience. Thank you very much for again giving me an